is the preferred solution by participants. Great. So having started with that now, I'm going to introduce Cesar Aliaga. He's head of Waste Recycling and Recovery Unit at ITENE, a packaging institute based in Valencia in Spain. But most important of all is that he's the coordinator of PlastiCircle, a project funded by the European Commission that is now in its last 6 months, 7 months, so nearly finishing, so with quite a lot of results to explain. So Cesar, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you, Meritxell, for your introduction. I agree with all the people saying that it's a pity not to be today in Alba Iulia. Actually, this is one of our pilots. We were here in Valencia visiting the pilot also in Utrecht. But now, in our last pilot in Alba Iulia, it's not possible for us to be there in person because of the situation. But we are going to do it in a virtual way. So I hope that all the participants, you will have the opportunity to see what is happening there and to have the feeling that what we are improving there in Alba Iulia regarding plastic packaging. So I will briefly introduce the project, PlastiCircle, and then of course I will leave the floor for explaining the pilots in detail, and especially the pilot of Alba Iulia, no? Which is our main activity in the project right now, okay? So PlastiCircle tries to face the problem of the packaging plastic waste, because actually currently we are generating around 27 million tons per year of plastic packaging, and only 31% is recycled, and that means a really high economic impact and environmental impact. Economic impact because we are investing a lot of money with the landfilling of this material. We have to pay for landfilling this material, and on the other side we are not getting value from this plastic material. So it's both ways: direct cost and also cost of opportunity cost. And also regarding the environmental impact is like very high as well, and it's similar to heating 1 million houses during 94 years in only 1 year. So that means the plastic problem is a really issue now, no? If we are not managing it well. So packaging is actually the main responsible, let's say, of the plastic problem, because it represents a really high percentages. And we really think that the problem can be solved if we get more, or we collect more material, if we increase the quality, and if we really develop new applications for this plastic material. So there is a lot of opportunities. It's not only an issue, but also a really important opportunity in the following years. So that's why in PlastiCircle, we are trying to develop several technologies in four areas: in the area of collection, to be able to collect more material and with more quality; in the area of the transport, in order to be more efficient in the transporting of the material from the cities to the recycling plants; also sorting, because if we are able to separate materials by the typology of polymer, then it will be easier, the recycling. So sorting is very important. And finally, recycling, because we want to develop new products, because the higher value of the product is it makes actually that the recycling rates will increase. So really important to develop new products. So we are participating 20 partners in PlastiCircle project. We have research institutes, we have trade associations, also recyclers, waste management companies, and also municipalities, for instance, Alba Iulia. And in the part of collection, this is the first area of research. In the part of collection, we are developing, or we have developed actually, smart containers in order to compensate citizens. That means that the better you do it, the more benefit you will get. Actually, the system works. Just one moment. Yeah, yes, the system works that the citizens are registering, then they get an identification card, and with this identification card they can go to the smart container, and the container provides the citizen with a label, and this label is sticked to the plastic bag, and then the system knows that this bag is owned by this citizen. No? Then in the recycling plan, there are a characterization protocol in which we know the quality of this bag. And depending on this, we are giving some compensation to the citizen. So this is, let's say, a system of pay as you throw, but adapted for these big containers, these urban containers. So the system has been implemented in the different pilots, and actually then my colleagues from Valencia and also from Alba Iulia will comment more in detail regarding how the system is working and what are the preliminary results. Regarding transport, we are providing also the containers with a filling level measurement system that lets the trucks to know which containers are full and which containers are not, in order to optimize the routes and in order to be more efficient in the collection of the waste. So this is also very important output of the project. This technology is also being implemented in the different pilots in Valencia, in Alba Iulia, and also in Utrecht. So we will see it later. Regarding sorting, we have a very innovative company located in Spain that they are developing an innovative machine in order to sort even better the plastics. Even we are sorting films, which is really an issue because of the lightweight of this material is more difficult to separate them, but we are working also on this, no? On those an innovative sorter. And finally, with these collected, transported and sorted plastics, we are developing really high value applications, which are foam boards, automotive parts, bituminous roofing membranes, garbage bags, roofing felts, urban furniture, fences. So we have five industries working on those products. So we really hope that after the project, they will be able to sell these innovative recycled products made from post-consumer plastics. So which are the benefits of the project? So actually we have technological benefits because we have new technologies for the collection, transport and sorting technologies, and also innovative products. Also in the social and economical point of view, we intend to develop new businesses, new companies, and also more recycled material in the EU market. And regarding the environmental point of view, the benefit is very clear because we are contributing to reduce landfilling and incineration of waste, and also to reduce the use of virgin material. Because if we are using recycled materials, then we don't really need to use virgin materials coming from not renewable resources. And where do we stand? So we have developed already the collection and transport technologies, and we have tested them in Valencia and in Utrecht in our two first pilots. Then the sorting prototype is already ready, and recycling, we have the lab the materials in a lab scale. And what are we doing now in the 7 months that we are still forward in the project, because we are now in the month 41? We are working now in the pilot in Alba Iulia. Actually, we are now in the last month of this pilot. Then my colleague Valentin will give more details on this. Then regarding the sorting, we are finishing the prototype and also finishing the recycled products in order to be able to be launched in the market as soon as possible. So you can get involved, of course, in the project. You can visit our webpage. Also, you can follow us in Twitter. And also here you have the link to our project video in case you want to see in 3 minutes time what are we doing in the project. So before giving the floor to my next colleague explaining the pilots, I wanted to show also this Google Earth presentation. It's very innovative, just for you to know and to locate the different pilots that we are doing. As I mentioned before, we have three pilots. One is in Spain, in Valencia. It was the first one, that was last year. Then in Utrecht, in the Netherlands. And finally in Alba Iulia, Romania, is the pilot that we are doing right now. And in which and that's why we are today together to explain what are the results in Alba Iulia. Then, first of all, the pilot in Spain, as I mentioned before, was in Valencia. Valencia is a quite big city located in the east of Spain, And the pilot was in the district of San Marcelino, which is in the south of the city. It's a district with 10,000 people living there, and the pilot was...
Sorry to interrupt. We don't see the Google Earth presentation. We still see the PowerPoint one.
Ah, sorry. Yeah. So I will try to share again. Can you see it now? Yes? Okay.
Yes, from slide six.
Six, yeah. Yeah, in the previous slides, I was just showing the map of Europe and then going to Valencia and then to San Marcelino, which is our first pilot. Here you can see a picture of the street, of one street of this district of, as I mentioned before, 10,000 people. We located there 25 containers, and we really make all the people to be engaged. Later on in the presentation of Julian, it will be more detail on the pilot of Valencia. Then our second pilot was in Utrecht, in the Netherlands. It was in the district of Terbeide. I hope I'm pronouncing it well, because it's difficult for me. Yeah, it was also a pilot. It was a bit different, this pilot, because they were having some initial technology already, but it was very useful for the project in order to compare technologies from PlastiCircle with other technologies. And also we did a lot of work in the part of the transport, in the transport optimization, let's say. And finally, the last pilot, which is, sorry, here you can see also pictures of the district of Terbaide. And finally, our last pilot, the pilot in which we are working now, and the pilot that we will explain today in detail, is the pilot of Romania, the pilot of Alba Iulia. And here you can see also a picture of the city. Regarding this pilot, yes, Valentin will explain more in detail how are the results and how are everything going, because we have to take into account that we are in the really last stage of the pilot. So it's still alive, no? But it will be closing in the following weeks. So thank you for your attention on this, and then we can move to the next pilot.
Perfect. Before we move to the next pilot, Cesar, just a couple of questions that were posted in the chat. Somebody was asking for municipal solid waste, biodegradable bags were seen as used in Valencia. If yellow bin is also a smart container, which type of bag is used?
Yeah, can you repeat the question, Marichelle?
Yeah, for municipal solid waste, biodegradable bags were seen as used in Valencia. If yellow bin is also a smart container, which type of bag is used?
Yeah, I don't know if I understood well the question, but I mean that yes, we use in the pilot a specific bag. We can use it any bag in the future, no? But for the pilot itself, we use a specific bag with a different color, because it was easier for us to recognize who were participating and who not. So we used like a very light orange bags, but we can use any type of bag. And then regarding the biodegradable materials and so on, I don't know if that was also the question related. This material can be also, so this is a different material, because that can go to the organic container, no? Or the container for the collection of organic waste.
We have another question, Cesar, and with that we will move to the next one. Doesn't mean that you cannot continue putting questions in the chat. We will collect them and also answer them later. How exactly did the participants get recorded?
Yeah, actually it was a platform in which when they were registering themselves, they were signing that they wanted to participate. And then the system, let's say, recorded the participation or the data of this citizen in order to have this information. No, then we didn't work with the specific data of the citizen. We worked just with a number, with an encrypted number. And then once they were participating every day, so the system, not us, but the system know that this person was the citizen participating.
Great, thanks, Cesar. I'm gonna reply. Actually, there was a question if we plan to have any other Spanish cities involved. The pilots of the cities are three, as mentioned by Cesar, it's been Valencia, Utrecht in the Netherlands, and then Alba Iulia in Romania. The idea is not to have more pilots now, but of course, we welcome replication of the PlastiCircle approach. So if any city is interested, please don't hesitate to contact us and we will let you know how you can do it and what are the steps to follow. I would like to thank Cesar and move to then to the second speaker of today, who is Julian Torralba. Julian, he is European Union Project Manager at Las Naves in Valencia, in Spain. Las Naves is an innovation center that is connected to the city of Valencia that is promoting urban innovation. They are also involved in the PlastiCircle project and specifically in the pilot in Valencia. And they've been the ones working a lot with citizen engagement. And this is what Julian is going to tell us about today, how they managed to get so many people on board in this project. Julian, all yes. Yours.
Hello, good morning to everyone. Thank you for the introduction. I know today it's more about Alba Iulia, but anyway, I would just let us know as an introduction, that's what we did in Valencia, because we were the first pilot city to test the innovation related to collection and to domestic sorting. So let's start. The first thing we did was about recognizing the area. The pilot area, as Cesar said, is a district in the south part of Valencia. That would be the whole city. And then, of course, we have lots of statistics data. We knew the population, the area, the density, how many containers, everything. But did we know something about the people living there? But really, no, we didn't know nothing about them. So before, we just addressed to them by tailoring a communication campaign to get them involved. We have to know first how was composed the population, how was their knowledge about the circular economy and their insights about recycling and plastic and packaging and sorting at home. So the first thing we did was running several tools to get their feedback about how they feel about the plastic sorting and packaging sorting. So we ran a lot of workshops with the citizens and with the street surveys and also meeting with key stakeholders of the district, such as the neighborhood associations and other associations, as cultural associations and elder people associations in the district, which were very, very, very useful to get to know which were the main concerns about the plastic sorting and the plastic collection in the district. So we get a little, as I say, we got a lot of valuable information that help us to tailor our communication campaign to make it more fruitful, to make it more successful. For instance, in the first approach that we had was to do it everything online, to get the registration and information online. But after this meeting with the people, we just realized that the average of elder people in the district was higher than the rest of the city. So we couldn't just rely just on online communication and online channel. So we were pretty sure that we had to be in the street. So we, during the months of the pilot, which were from May 2018 until October, so we were really active in the streets by having people people informing the people and registering the people in situ and in the streets to get information, to make them understand what is for, and to make sure that they to boost the participation of the people in the project. Another important insight that I like to highlight was that although everyone more or less was let's say used to the concept of recycling, it was not the case with the concept of circular economy, which was very surprising. We didn't know actually what was done with the waste that was collected, how was it treated, which is the benefits and of doing like that, and how this action that they do at home, that this is an effort for them to do it right, how they can benefit from that, direct and indirect benefits from that. So we, of course, it was about making good sorting and good collection, but we were pretty clear for us that we have to also explain the whole cycle of the circular economy, including areas such as the transformation and the reuse of the plastic as raw material. So we run a lot of workshops dedicated to specific population groups, such as children, other people, housewives, always using recycled day-to-day items so that they can fully understand what is for this project, and beyond that they do it right at home. To boost the participation, although we just put a lot of efforts in doing in being present at the street, we didn't want to dismiss also the tools, the social media and the online tools. So we also, which was quite new for us, was to involve people through their participation in social media by, let's say, reinforcing this idea of circular economy by organizing several activities not directly involved with collection and sorting, but with circular economy, such as to be installing a plastic recycle bench in the district, and then we just launch the challenge to find it and to make a picture and uploading. And also, for instance, this we organize a exhibition about pictures about the impact of the waste management in the environment. So the people have to also to comment which were the most impressive pictures and why. So the idea was, as always, to make people think about this this process, and so that they get a bigger picture of the process, not only that they have to sort this item and this plastic and this object in the right bin. Of course, the results, we have very, let's say, technical results, positive results. I would mention that the trips, the transport, relating to collection, the less kilometers were needed, because the sensors in the bins were just skipping the sensor that the field level was not enough. So a lot of kilometers were safe, what means less CO2 emissions. And also one of the most important outcomes, technical outcomes, was that the fraction of the unwanted materials was very improved in those participants. But for us, what was more important is to translate these results in understandable messages for the people, and get the people involved, and get the people, let's say, aware of what they had achieved by their participation during these 6 months. So we just ran a party about to deliver these awards. As Cesar has mentioned, people participating gets points by participating through the different sources. And then the last day, one day in December, just before Christmas, we just ran a party in the district so that they can come and they can get what they have been awarded. So we just take advantage to ask them about how they felt about the project, and the outcome was quite positive. Here you have some of the insights of the testimonies of the people about how important was also the positive contribution of being awarded to do it right. It had definitely boosted their participation in the project, what make us think about this kind of rewarding system can be useful in the future. We were very happy to see that they better understood the idea of the circular economy it was very rewarding, and about they felt also very, let's say, like that they contributed to the saving the CO2 emissions and to have less impact in the environment. Here, we don't have time to run the video. We have a nice video about this final party, but you can check it in YouTube. It is, if you have, you feel curiosity about it. And that would be all from our side. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask.
Thanks, Julian, for sharing these impressive lessons learned and also this communication campaign that worked so well, and also how you managed to involve people and how you managed to explain to people how they had contributed to CO2 emission savings and others. If you have any questions for Julian, please post them in the chat, but we will move to the next speaker so that we can have more time. Also, for you to know that today, Jan from the city of Utrecht, our city second city pilot, is also here. So if you have any questions for Utrecht also, please feel free to post them in the chat. We don't have time today because it's a study virtual tour in Alba Iulia to focus much more on Utrecht, but Jan would be also happy to answer any questions if needed. We would now like to show you a video about the Alba Iulia pilot so that you get a bit more of information of how everything is being managed now in Alba Iulia. I will share my screen so that you can watch it.
Mi-am făcut înscrierea. Am urmărit tot ce înseamnă acest proiect. Mi-am completat datele personale. Am trimis către proiect. Am primit în urma acestuia un cod de 4 cifre, un cod de identificare pentru a proteja datele personale. Se primește pliantul cum să reciclezi. Aici e vorba cum trebuie reciclat, deci trebuie să fie sticle curate, trebuie să nu fie contaminate, doar plastic, trebuie presate, nu se pune plastic în pungă, deci se reciclează separat. În kitul de bun venit am primit și saci în care eu pun plasticele. Aici, după ce îl duc la gunoi, aici va trebui să punem codul, acela care se va primi la container. Bine să reciclăm plasticul pentru că așa avem o viață mai sănătoasă și nu o să fie atâtea probleme de sănătate.
Împreună cu o echipă din Valencia am pregătit 21 de containere pe care am adaptat senzorul pentru umplere și înăuntru mai este și senzor pentru temperatură în caz că se prinde containerul sau ia foc, se încălzește. Iar aici este aparatul care cetățeanul, după ce vine cu sacul, apasă pe acest buton pe care își pune cartela, iasă o etichetă, eticheta se pește pe sac și se introduce în container. După care noi o să ridicăm containerele în fiecare zi sau de câte ori ne spune senzorul că sunt pline, le golim și procedăm la selectarea deșeurilor care se află în container. Noi pe camioanele noastre avem un sistem de GPS montat, dar pentru eficiență în plus montăm un sistem Canvas care ne ajută să vedem eficiența și monitorizarea desfășurării activității în context mai bun și pentru a face oarecare economie.
În momentul de față au fost folosite două fracții pentru deșeuri în zonele care sunt dens populate, caracterizate de foarte multe blocuri de locuințe. O fracție umedă, care înseamnă deșeu menajer comun, și o fracție uscată pentru materiale reciclabile. În acest moment, legislația românească prevede o îmbunătățire sensibilă a domeniului reciclării prin obligativitatea utilizării a patru fracții de materiale reciclabile. Din punct de vedere obiective, pilotul din Alba Iulia, desigur că are obiectivele generale ale proiectului, dar accentul este pus pe partea de legătură cu cetățenii, informare a cetățenilor și testare a soluțiilor, în special a containerelor inteligente, completate de celelalte soluții tehnice pe care le-am implementat împreună cu partenerul Polaris.
Înregistrarea participanților în cadrul proiectului s-a realizat exclusiv prin platforma online pusă la dispoziție în cadrul proiectului. Ulterior înregistrării, aceștia au fost identificați în cadrul platformei și contactați de către reprezentanții din cadrul primăriei Alba Iulia în vederea înaintării unui pachet de bun venit.
Okay, hope you have a better feeling now of what Alba Iulia is doing in its pilot. I hope you enjoyed the video. We will also share the link so that you can have it. And I'm happy now to introduce you to our city guide today. It's Valentin. Valentin is working for the Municipality of Alba Iulia, and he is the person who has all the details about the Alba Iulia pilot. So Valentin, happy if you tell us more.
Thank you, Marixel. Do you hear me, yeah? And you see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay, so unfortunately, because of the COVID context, we are not able to welcome you directly in person in Alba Iulia, so we adopted this virtual tour. We hope that you will find more about PlastiCircle and the pilot in Alba Iulia. From the very beginning, I must mention that Alba Iulia, it's a smaller city compared with Valencia and Utrecht. And we are making the pilot in a completely different context, technical and social. So Alba Iulia is placed in the center of Romania. And it's in the eastern part of the EU. We don't have very good recycling rates. And technical solutions at the moment are different to those from Valencia and Utrecht. Here you have the coverage of the city. There are about 74,000 inhabitants. Density is quite high. Majority of population is active, and Alba Iulia is the capital of Alba district. Alba Iulia is a historical city. It has about 2,000 years. And in the central part of the city, it was a Roman citadel, after that a medieval citadel, and now is the biggest southeastern Goban citadel. And the city is constructed around the citadel, and our pilot area is next to the citadel area. So one question was about the pilot area and how to choose it. We have a compact area. In the pilot meetings, we decided to go in the blocks area, which is quite dense. And we were searching for locations well social integrated and having about 20 containers, which is our target during the pilot. Of course, that many citizens ask us why we are not going to other parts of the city, but it's just a pilot project. So I think that the results are statistically relevant. About the area of the pilot, you can see more on the next slide. So we must wait. And now we have a street view, like you are in Alba Iulia, This is a goldish street, and here we have a local school and blocks. And Ansberg Street is also quite similar. And here on the right part, you see already a container near this area of blocks. Now, about the coverage area. From the technical point of view, and I saw there are some questions, we have the smart containers, and on the right side, you can see a picture of the container. In fact, there are two communication devices inside. One is the Felix sensor, which is transmitting to the platform in Valencia data about the level of the waste in the container using a GSM system. On the right side, you see the labeling box, which is giving labels to citizens accessing the device with the RFID card. A question was why we are giving labels to citizens. The idea is that we are going to manually characterize the content of the bags. And the device is matching the information of the RFID card with the label in order to give eco points to citizens. In red, you see the areas covered by the containers servicing the two zones. And on the right side, you see a picture of a filling sensor, which was mentioned in the movie. It has also temperature and shock sensors. We decided to go on 20 containers because in the area we already have 18 prepared locations. And you see how we placed the transceivers. The device for labels is using LoRaWAN communication. So we put small transceivers in the area in order to receive using LoRa the signal from the labeling device. And after that, using 3G, we are sending data to the Valencia platform. From the very beginning, from the pilot implementation, it's a kind of replica of the Valencia pilot, because technically and socially, it's much closer to the Valencia implementation. Utrecht has already a more advanced system using sensor and data transmission. But it was a lot of work, and we want to thank to our partners, especially to ICLEI, ITENE, SAV, SINTEF, and all the rest of the partners. Without this implementation, wasn't be possible. What to see is areas and how we put the transceivers. We use two public buildings location, and the rest are transmitters in citizens' apartments. Here you have the main headquarter of Polaris. Polaris is our partner in the project and is the waste management company in the area. And here is the destination point where the sorting platform is placed. You don't see it on Google Maps because it's made quite recently. In fact, was finished 5 months ago. So I think that now you have more technical and area details, and we can go to other amounts using a presentation. Questions till now, because I think that you already have a better idea about the pilot after you saw the movie and the implementation area. And now we are going to see more details, and I hope that we'll clarify also other aspects. And we will share immediately the screen. Okay. Now let's make it larger. You see it?
Yeah, thanks, Valentin.
Okay, so let's go on. Already mentioned that it's a different context. Romania is not at a very high level of recycling materials, unfortunately. So there are a lot of modification in the national level and also at local level. Soon we'll have a district integrated platform for recycling materials. But the accent in our case was put on informing and evolving citizens. We found a lot of details about correctly recycling, not using contaminated or sanitary plastics and so on. It's giving us a lot of info about quantities and qualities of the materials in the waste. And of course, it's a first test of innovative solution. Results of the pilot are very important for the future projects of the municipality, beginning with a project in which we are going to use over 130 locations using underground containers. But RFID cards and signaling and route optimization are already very interesting for the next solutions. Yes, our pilot is different from what you saw in Valencia, because the initial plan was to start the pilot in April and have a strong collaboration with the social science faculty from the local university, have meetings, events, online and offline registrations, and so on. Unfortunately, beginning with March, we entered in an emergency state, and after that, in the alert state. So social distancing, no workshops, meetings face-to-face, and so on. We were obliged to go mainly online. And for offline, we involved the block administrators in order to put posts on each block in the area, and also flyers. But we went mainly online. One question was how citizens are registering. Well, going to our website, reading the details of the project and entering the platform and giving the details. After that, we gave them welcome kits. Here you see how we adapted to the container, which is just 1.1 cubic meters compared with over 3 cubic meters in Valencia and Utrecht. Valencia is using on-street containers, Utrecht is using underground. And we also have to adapt the transmission rate, because the containers are smaller. In this moment, we are emptying the containers daily, and we are trying to improve that using the filling sensors. And we change the frequency to 3 hours in order to have better information about containers. About characterization, you saw images from the ramp. You see here three different fractions and also PlastiCircle bags mentioned by Cesar. That orange bag and the labels. The platform has automatically a system in which we are entering the quality of individual characterization in order to give them points for that. And after that, you see in the right image how we implemented the canvas on a Polaris truck. You have here details about the registering platform for citizens. One question probably is related to how we managed to have just citizens in the pilot area. And the answer is we use the GIS system. And when he's entering the address, if it's not the block on the street, is not registered. And after that, of course, we change and improve the platform, which is in Valencia. For example, now questionnaires and activities are already in the platform in order to give feedback to participants. These are online and offline materials. We use a character and also a lot of details in our offline materials, because we weren't able to make face-to-face events. And here you have what's inside for participants. He see his ID, his number of points, and his activities. And here we are giving eco points for correct recycling, quantity of plastics, participating in social media activities, participating to trainings and answering and giving feedback to the project. And here you see some symbolic rewards we are going to give to the most involved citizens in the pilot. We started with a workshop with block administrators, but just after that we entered in the emergency state. We have a press release, and on July 1st we put the containers in place and announced everybody that we are starting the pilot. You have some images here. We are meeting citizens to give them the welcome kits. And during August, we saw that number of participants is not going to be quite high. So we adopted an info kiosk for a short period, and the results came immediately. And now that you have probably most of the details you were curious to find about, we are going to the city hall, and we are welcomed by our vice mayor with mayor attributes.
PlastiCircle e încă un exemplu foarte bun despre modul în care Alba Iulia, ca partener în proiecte europene și implicit ca reprezentant al României, își actualizează prioritățile și aliniază în contextul european. Pentru România este încă o acțiune de pionierat, iar noi la Alba Iulia ne-am obișnuit să ne asumăm acest rol de trendsetter. Sunt sigur că Alba Iuliene se vor implica în cel mai serios și activ mod și în acest proiect și că îl putem transforma într-un reper și un exemplu de bună practică și pentru restul României.
So, first results. Yes, usually the waste is quite mingled in Alba Iulia, so we have difficulties in general characterization. But good news is that the amount of plastic in PlastiCircle dedicated containers is quite good. And there are some areas where people are looking at that label and see that it's just for plastic. And you have an image with a PlastiCircle bag, and you see around it's just plastic. So, it's not the majority of containers, but these are good news. People are learning how to use a dedicated container just for plastic. So it's a starting for the next project. And the results of participation in this moment, you see that we have over 250 participants involved. In fact, it's just one member for family. Total number of citizens is close to 500. And thank you, women are more involved than men. And you see that the main age area is 35 to 44. So these are details from Alba Iulia, and we are waiting for your questions.
Thanks, Valentin, for all these insights about the pilot in Alba Iulia and for guiding us through your city today. I would like to put two questions that were in the chat. One was coming from CSC, saying great project, and this would be more to Cesar to answer. How is the technical equipment and the prices funded? And what happens when the project ends? Will the economic incentives continue?
Okay, regarding the cost of the systems, we are taking into account always the cost, but of course, with the economy of scales, they will go down. As far as we know, the system per container should be always below 300 euros, because otherwise it's not cost effective. So we are now a bit behind this cost, but we are investigating as well how to reduce the cost in order to be below this limit. And also after the project, if the rewards will be followed, it will depend on the city. Actually, for the cities, it's also an economic benefit to get more plastics, because that will make also more profitable the collection. But I wanted to say that not only can we use this information for rewards, but also for the taxes. We can also use this information in the future. Of course, it will depend on the different cities, different situation, and different, because maybe politically it's not very easy to do it. But in the future, we could also use this information in order to adapt the taxes and to make like a reduction of taxes for people doing it well, or increasing taxes for people doing it not that well. So the possibilities are like very, very high on this.
Thanks, Cesar. Then maybe a second question that would be to Julian, to Valentin, to Jan. It's regarding also the printing labels. A couple of attendees, Jens and Mircea, were mentioning that maybe it could be done via the mobile phone with applications without so much printing, or including also the mobile phone number of people in the label. I think it has to do with the printing and it has to do with data confidentiality. So if anyone of you wants to comment on that.
I will try to answer that question. It's a good question because yes, device labels need the maintenance, and some users are not using the devices properly, and we must troubleshoot it frequently. But please keep in mind that is a pilot project. In the moment, we are generating a label with a card, and we have the information already in the platform. If people are going to write their mobile number, or probably better, is their personal four-digit code, that means manual processing. So in the scope of the project, we try an automatic approach in order to count echo points for number of bags, and after that for characterization. And mobile number, it's already GDPR. So I don't know if it's okay. But the idea is for the pilot, we are using this procedure, which is quite automatic, need maintenance. On long term, maybe we can analyze other ideas too.
Yes, I do agree. In Valencia, we had, let's say that the maintenance of these labor dispensers were the biggest pain of the pilot, because we need constant. On one hand, constant maintenance because of vandalism, and on the other hand, because people just needed to better instructions how to use it. No, so yeah, we also did a lot of effort on training people in using the machines. So yes, another ways of registering people and of identifying people backs with people should be a good idea, or just improving these items. But for the pilot, in the end, it ran quite well. So
I forgot that another reason is that the label and the platform also knows the number of container, because the truck is taking the waste from all the containers, and now in the platform we already know how many bags were thrown in each container. So it gives us coverage information.
Yeah. I'd like to mention that it's 11 o'clock. This was the time to finish. But if it's okay for participants and speakers, we would run for extra 5-10 minutes so that we can cover some more questions, because otherwise it would be like ending pretty like now. We have another question by Christina from AVEP. She's asking if, according to your experience, which are the main barriers to replicate the experience in other cities or areas of the same cities already tested in these pilots? And open to anyone who wants to answer.
Can you repeat the question, Meritxell?
Sure. Which are the main barriers to replicate the experience in other cities or areas of the same cities already tested in these pilots?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe I can introduce the answer. I think the main barrier, actually, the system is quite versatile. So it has been designed in order to be adapted to the different situation, because in the different cities we have different type of buildings, we have different types of containers and so on. So the installation of the system is quite easy. Of course, we have now the prototype, and we have to improve even this prototype, no? But initially the installation is quite easier. But the main barriers, I think, are to engage people. I think to engage people and to engage the town hall itself. So I think it should be something decided together with cities and waste managers. So it's not something that can be decided by only one agent. No, so maybe this is, I would say this is the main barrier to make like an agreement with all the involved stakeholders, and also to make people to participate.
So political commitment should be one thing, like a barrier, Cesar? Political commitment? Should
Yeah, also political commitment, because if we are working with rewards, in our experience, it's quite easy to sell in one city. But if we are using this for taxes, then it's more difficult to be implemented. But I think things are changing, and people are more and more, let's say, open to this kind of initiatives. And in order to boost good actions and good behaviors, that can is a very powerful tool.
Would you say, Julian, Valentin, Jan, did you encounter any other kind of barriers that you would like to mention about?
Yeah, if I may, Valencia City Council is participating in this project because this is a line of work that they already had before the starting of the project. I mean, to reward the citizens for increasing the rates of sorting. Of any kind of waste, in this case packaging waste. We choose the awards system because it was the easiest to implement during this period of time, but this kind of system, perhaps is the most in terms of budget, would be very budget if to extend it to the whole city would be perhaps very too expensive. So other lines of work, now that we have proof that thanks to PlastiCircle that to reward the people works, something we can explore other lines of rewarding them, not through direct items, direct awards, perhaps with public services, access to public services like bus, public transport, or theater, or other services, to involve also the private agents to get discounts for use any other services and private management, or even as the best solution, not the best, but the most interesting is that through the tax system, what, as Cesar has said, it takes time because it is a very lot of political governance barriers to do it through this way. But let's say that PlastiCircle, the seed has been planted. I mean, the city council is aware that it works, so that perhaps this kind of system has to be improved to save, not to spend so that budget to be extended to the whole city.
I can add that a question is related to the budget. Well, sensors, devices, dedicated containers we used in Alba Iulia were in the project budget, but other activities were made internally. It's not very difficult to replicate technically. Probably, yes, the labeling device is not always necessary if it's not a pilot and is going to be on a larger scale. Probably using a card and a locking system to the container can do the job instead of labeling. It's very important, and the results, preliminary results show that it's very important to know what economies can be made in order to have a better collection and route optimization. And I think that the main barrier is not technical. In fact, during our PlastiCircle project, we have also analyzing the business models for this kind of projects. It's more about the human implication. So there are about 20% of people which are very willing to implement this kind of solutions, and we must take aboard the other people.
Great, thanks, Valentin. I would like to put the last question to Cesar, and then I would invite everyone to turn on their camera so that we can take a family picture. Cesar, one last question about the future. So what are the next steps? What would you recommend other cities if they want to do something? What are the three pilot cities going to do with all these results? You're muted, Cesar.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, for me as a coordinator, it will be great to see all those results in the market as soon as the project finished next year. So it will be very soon. And actually, we are working with Kim, with one company. Actually, Ariadna is there. I can see her in the screen. So we are working in order to help partners in order to exploit commercially the results, not only the smart container, not only the transport system, but also the sorter and also the recycled products. No? So we are willing to see all those products in the market as soon as possible. And then for the cities, if they want to implement solutions similar to that, I think is the moment now to start contacting us and we can help them to implement it. So after May 2021, that will be everything over PlastiCircle, I think is the starting point in order to implement those technologies, not only in Valencia, Alba Iulia, and Utrecht, but also in many others European cities.
Great, thanks, Cesar. So I would invite everyone to turn on their cameras if you have one, so that we can take this picture of everyone. In the meantime, just to remind you that we have a Twitter account, Circ Economy. You can follow us there. You can join us in LinkedIn. And if you have any further questions, you can also write us in info@plasticcircle.eu. I would really like to thank everyone also for being so active in the chat with so many comments, so many suggestions. It's been a really nice tour today. So we are happy to have been joined by so many people. And I would just say probably now, cheese. So that everyone smiles and we can take a nice picture. Cheers! So thank you very much everyone and hope to see you soon. And any questions, as you know, we're always happy to answer them via email, Twitter, or in any other way. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much and congrats.
Thank you.